Welcome to this introduction to Aspen PIMS. This video will walk you through the very basics of PIMS, such as navigation and menus. Okay, let's get started. Okay, the first thing we'll do, we'll double-click on PIMS to open the application. It will check the license file first, and then load. Another way to open PIMS is to go to the Start menu, All Applications, scroll down to Planning, and open PIMS here. If it opens to a gray screen, that means that PIMS doesn't have a model to open. So the first thing we'll do is open a model. Before we open a model though, just to let you know, I'm using version 8.8, so yours may look slightly different. Now, to open a model, click on the Model menu, then go to Open. This opens a dialog box for us to search through. Look for the folder containing the PIMS model as well as all the associated files. For example, select Volume Sample and then press OK. After pressing OK, PIMS fills up the tree structure with the appropriate items. Now the model will load. It's important to note that this Volume Sample model is a demo that comes with PIMS. You can open it from the following directory. On the C drive, you can go to Users, Public, Public Documents, AspenTech, Aspen PIMS, and then PIMS. And you'll see a selection of models that you can use as demos. The Gulf Coast model is also one that we'll be using later. I duplicated the volume sample demo and called it a new version just for the how-to video so that we didn't overwrite the existing demo. The other way to open a model is through an archived model which a colleague would have sent you. To do this, select Model, then Unarchive Model. We created this zipped model for this demo in the same file location. Once you have selected the zip file, change the destination home directory to the location of the zip file and press OK. So now that our model is open, we can show you the next set of features. This is the model tree. The model tree contains all the information required for a PIMS model. PIMS works with Excel files attached to certain branches of the model tree. This is in the section called Tables. By expanding any branch of the tree, you can click on the attached Excel file, open up the spreadsheet, and make changes to the data. For example, this is the case file, and we'll cover more about this later. But for now, once you make a change, all you need to do is save it in Excel, close the worksheet, and it will be saved to the PIMS model, attached to the model tree. If you need more help on the specific information that needs to go into each table, then you can right-click on the table and go to the Help menu. This opens the context-sensitive help that has a wealth of information about each table, along with examples of what to include in them. Above the table section is the model settings, which contains the basic settings that a user can alter. The general settings contains the model title, the basis of the model, volume or weight, as well as whether you want to fix the material balance with the fixed bal checkbox. We'll talk more about that later, but for now we're going to leave it off. The reporting section contains the reports that are generated after a PIMS run. To cut down on the time taken to run a case stack, you can deselect reports that are not being used. We will cover the basic settings in AO in another video. Underneath the tables section is the reports section. This section contains all the reports that are generated after PIMS has solved a case. These reports summarize the important information that is solved from PIMS. For example, the full solution report had the purchases and sales as well as the economic summary and capacity utilization. There are no reports here yet since we haven't run any cases. We'll show you this later too. Thank you for watching. If you would like more information, visit our website at www.aspentech.com and click on Products, then Petroleum Supply Chain.